So the first kind of case study or successful, should we call it a mission, is in Guyana.
Yes.
What did you achieve and why that nation in particular?
We've been working in Guyana for the last few years. The president and the government over there is very eager to use technology to improve the country and use the newfound money from gas to actually have a positive impact. So we've been building a public-private partnership with them for the last few years, bringing advanced technology, starting with telemedicine, and now launching the drone delivery of medication, and bringing back from those rural indigenous communities blood samples or other goods to the regional hospitals.
Can we talk a little bit about the technology? You know, I cover NVIDIA very closely, and for a long time, Jensen Huang's been telling me about real-world AI and physical AI. You use NVIDIA as a partner, but how does that work?
There are two technologies that are transforming what we can do in those remote places. Traditionally, you haven't been able to go there physically. Drone is changing this. And you haven't been able to communicate. Drones is changing this. The NVIDIA piece comes on top of it, allows us to automate and monitor and perform drone operation in a much safer, more autonomous way. And that directly ties into the costs. And when you are dealing with the next 1 billion people in rural population, one of the major considerations is innovating at a cost point.
Right.
And that's why NVIDIA is transformative here as well.
On the data side, or you have physical silicon inside of the...
We have physical silicon inside because the AI is moving to the edge. So we actually have both the Starlink on the drone and the NVIDIA on the drone to do real-time processing of what's happening on the drone so it can fly autonomously in a safer
way.
That's
astonishing. You know, Starlink is available in so many formats and mediums, you know, industrial scale, on airplanes, in the home. How did you negotiate with them to get a receiver locally onto the drone?
The Starlink Mini is kind of the smallest model of the Starlinks. Drones, you know, we're not talking about a DJI small drone. We are looking on something that's better be called unmanned aircraft. And these are just growing every year now. Like, we can carry 25 pounds this year. By next, we are looking at 150 pounds unmanned aircraft.
Right.
So, yeah, you put a Starlink on it. And the moment you put Starlink, you completely transform how you can fly because the pilot can sit, view the weather, view the physical location, monitor throughout the flight. In
very low latency.
HD, almost no latency, sits with a joystick. You know, in the past, those technologies have only been available for expensive military usage.
Right.
We believe in drones for good. And the Starlink has been able to enable us to transform this, put the Starlink on the drones, and offer those services.
Ram, in my study and research of you, I know you to be more kind of involved in the smartphone market, historically working at Apple, other OEMs. How did you get into drones?
Oh, I've always been into aviation since I was a kid. And if you think about a drone nowadays, a drone is no longer that much of an aero challenge or aerospace challenge. A drone is much more of a computer with sensor and motors and software and communications that you need to come together. Well, that's what I did at Apple. That's what I did in Samsung, leading digital health. And that's where I started when I built the first phone in the world. It had a browser in 95. It's building the hardware and the software together to create amazing products.
Just very quick, you know, Zipline's a company that we've covered on this program deeply. It's very analogous in many ways what you're doing. They've been able to scale in different markets. Do you see them as the main competitor? Do you try to emulate them?
I think they're absolutely a fantastic company. And they're doing amazing things. We try to take a slightly different approach than them. They are much more vertically integrated, and everything needs to be technology powered. We believe in achieving balance between what I call AI and AGI. There is a space to use humans in the operation of drones, especially in rural indigenous places. And being able to balance, you know, you can have local people charge the drones, unpack the drones, have it land in the communities. It also means that you empower and educate local people. So